Okay, here we are again, back from our hiatus. We've got some people that don't have quite the internet connection they would like. Mike will be on only voice tonight, so you can have a picture of him because he's in a new house, and he's trying to get things set up. Also, you will notice that I've got some things different on my video than I had before. You'll see some things behind me that you didn't see before, because I got a new present that I'm excited to use, which is a green screen. So I'm going to be using the heck out of that. That will be fun. And let me get the last of these videos. I've got you guys fairly well set up. When we were last seen a couple of weeks ago, there was a big fight in the downstairs of the Argenvost hold, and there was a wall that came down which separated Victor and Sylvia from the fight that was going on. Victor eventually managed to stumble upon, almost fall through, a secret door in a cabinet, a wardrobe, which took him a little by surprise, and he wound up in the fight as well, which helped out the three that were trapped inside. Then Sylvia used her Bigby's hand to help break through the wall, but as the fight ended, she decided to follow the small smoke dragon, which had taken off on the corridor where they were on the investigation area where they'd been. The smoke dragon eluded her attempt to grab it and flew up some spiral staircases, which you can see behind me here. Basically, I am sitting in front of, let me move me over a bit, whoops. Move me over a bit so that I can, I gotta get the stairs back. Get my video rather than the stairs. But behind me is the spiral staircase, which Lynn went up, and I'm trying to move me so you can see more of it.
Bad choices. I mean, come on. How long has it been since I made a really bad choice on this character?
Bad choices.
I can always add a stamp over so.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, there's the spiral staircase behind me so that it's more visible to people. And
we can always do Sylvia to make us feel better about our choices.
Right.
Well, no, technically you guys have still made far worse choices than I've ever done. But still.
You're not alone.
It's kind of a toss-up. Especially
You see, we did, and then you did that.
Right. Yes. Yes. With her going up those stairs, it's up for grabs. Who makes the worst choices in the matter?
It's almost as if we're in a competition for bad choices.
Yeah, it's kind of like that, isn't it?
I mean, really? Are we going to start counting that? I mean, her first bad choice was following you guys, but...
All right, let's put some things up here so that we can see what's going on. We are with Lynn first tonight after she went up the stairs, and that needs to go away, and the dice roll box needs to come up. There we go. Alrighty, so when we take off tonight, we'll deal with what Lynn is doing. As you are coming up these stairs, what you face first off is a tattered black curtain that is hanging directly in front of you as you come out of the thing. It is swaying as if something has just passed through it or around it or whatever. There's movement in the thing. It's very beat up black cloth. In this,
don't die on us tonight.
Uh, Sorry about that.
It's all good.
So all you can see is just this little area where you are standing. So it is your last chance to turn around and go back where you came from. Are you going to proceed forward?
Proceeding forward with extreme caution, I am going to use the last few remaining minutes of the Big B's hand to gently push enough of the curtain aside so I can kind of get a better idea of what's on the other side.
All right. When you push it aside, you see a couple of things. You see your eye catches a last glimmer of the little smoke dragonette as it disappears around the corner at going some corridor that's heading south. You can see that the corridor you're on has a couple of doors on the north wall of it, and you can see a door directly opposite you, far end of the hall, with another door down there. And in the middle of the T of these two corridors, you see a pile of junk that is about 3 to 4 feet high in places, very much difficult terrain. And you look up, and above you, you see the entire ceiling above has collapsed onto the floor. There is an enormous hole that you can look up, and you can see sky, the cloudy, overcast, usual Barovian sky, through the hole that you are looking at. So you are more or less at the top of the castle, with the exception of the battlements. And we lost Lynn, so she comes.
There we go.
Yeah, sorry. Somehow it jumped out for whatever reason.
It does those kinds of things. It's computers. What else can you say?
Man, sorry if I messed anything up.
He who smiles when things go wrong has a computer to blame it on. So you can see the cloudy Barovian sky above you through this enormous hole that has dropped in the ceiling. Pretty much the hole extends from more or less about here all the way down to about here above you. And all the rubble has collapsed into this T. The dragonette flew over it quite easily, but it'll be more difficult for you to climb over it and follow it.
Observing the hallway itself, are there any more depictions of Argenthos?
No, this is a fairly barren hall. It doesn't have any pictures or anything on the walls. It's just a very simple area leading to other things, apparently.
Okay. How well is it lit down the hallway? The hole of the sky is
fine. Yeah. It's pretty well lit because you've got an enormous hole to the sky. You're on the verge in this area of standing outdoors because the hole is so large.
Okay. I am going to, since I'm assuming that since the Babala Saga fight to currently, I would have had time to repair.
You guys have been in here for the better part of an entire day. It's getting late in the day. It would probably be 4 o'clock, like, but you went to Valaki and were thoroughly repaired.
I was just thinking of the fact that the last time I used this, somebody had to have an issue with it. I'm going to take the Strahd puppet out of my bag. I'm going to cast a tiny servant on it.
Okay.
And double checking what the stuff is here. I'm just gonna pop the spell card up there just for reading's sake. I'm not casting it at a higher level. What the hell? I'm going to set it down on the floor, and I'm going to point down the stairs and go, okay, you know to stay away from the guy with the mask. Just get their attention and point them up this way and avoid getting kicked. So if he tries to kick you...
You mean you're telling it to stay away from Victor?
Victor, yeah. Just keep away from Victor. Just go downstairs and get their attention. And then come right back as soon as someone starts as soon as somebody that's a friend starts following you.
Okay.
I'll just send the tiny servant down there, and I'm gonna kind of
kick the baby.
I'm gonna eke in just a little bit to see what that is over here, where I just pinged.
Ping it again. I'm sorry, I was looking the other way.
So good.
Okay, so you're going to open that door and look in?
I guess, this is how I use all my spells before any combat happens. Am I allowed to use it? Cantrip mage hand to try and open the door gently? I'm not touching the fucking doors.
What you are rolling for stealth is for the ancient doorway and whether or not it will creak. So I to roll a dexterity save. To see if the door is in good enough shape to...
Okay. Ready or not, here we go. Yeah, I think I'll be fine.
Very good. Okay, let me undarken this room. I'll describe what you see here, and then I will take the things off so you can actually see it. But what you look at is what would have been a dining room. There are six chairs along each side of a long dining table, and there's dust and cobwebs hanging all over the room. There's a fireplace to your left in the room, and there are faded war banners hanging all over this with symbols of knights and various things. And at the heavy wooden table, there's an iron chandelier that hangs above the table. There's some oddly glowing lights, candles, like in the chandelier. And in the six chairs, which have backs carved like dragons, sitting in the six chairs, slumped, are six skeletal humans in tattered chainmail.
I'm gonna just carefully stay out of that room and see if there's any other... Oh, I don't think there's any other entrances, or at least from what I can see right now, beyond the collapsed rubble. Excuse me one second. Stop that.
Entrances to what?
Other rooms, like anything else that might hold something in it.
There is a doorway here, a doorway here, and a doorway at the end of the hall. Is the rubble blocking your view?
I mean, like, I'm assuming that I can't.
Well, it's no. I would say that you it comes up to like chest to shoulder height in places, but you can see over it.
Yeah. Okay. So, any corridor going down that way that I could see it to some extent.
Well, the dragonette went south in a corridor.
Oh yeah, yeah. So obviously, well, I figured it was basically involved at that point, but all right. So
the other doors are all closed on the halls.
All right. One last spell casting before I decide to wait like a good individual for the rest of my party.
That sounds a little reasonable.
You shouldn't do it.
Exactly.
Yeah, I know I shouldn't do it, but... Hey, I mean, I sent something downstairs to get you guys. Okay, whether you see it or not is the end. Yeah.
Alright, so do you want to just wait here before you move on? Because I want to get you to where there's a good stopping place.
Yeah, I'm just going to leave the room as is, but kind of keep an eye on it. But I'm going to investigate the rubble.
Okay, so you just...
Over here?
Okay, so you're going to walk up to the rubble and just kind of stop there looking through it. You don't see any shinies in it. It is definitely all building materials that are there.
I figured look for if possible to look for signs of what could have caused the collapse, if it was just natural or was it something that landed on it.
It is hard to tell from down here. Everything is pretty shattered and broken. Your feeling is you're not an engineer, and so you don't know if time merely rotted the beams and they collapsed, but the beams are largely like snapped in the middle. There's evidence of breakage, and then this heavy stonework that was supported by it has just collapsed in on it. So it's just big chunks of what in our modern terminology would be concrete chunks basically laying on the floor that has been shattered by either time or an event. But you don't know what the event would be if there was an event.
Okay, I figured I was just like looking for any signs of like claw marks or something like sillily obvious than that.
In this you do not see anything.
Okay. So I'll just kind of hang there, keep like an ear open on that room in case anything starts moving, and wait for the servant to come back.
All right. In that case, I will move to the downstairs as soon as the map decides to load, which it's just looking like it's in fog right now. And we are on this floor where the battle was held last time. Let's see, I need to take Sylvia's token off here. She went upstairs. And also take off the dragonette, which is not there at the moment. All right, so we have Apotus, Vlad, Victor, and Dirac all recuperating from this battle with a bunch of phantom-like warriors. And as you are standing there, the wall has been broken open. It is no longer there. It's collapsed. So let me try to get this. Shouldn't that be on?
I mean, I can pass through. It doesn't look like it's...
No, it's not. I'm just trying to get the visual off of the screen. That's all, guys. I'm trying to pick up...
Are any of the four of us more than halfway below health?
No.
Victor's healed up.
I think I was the only one that took damage, and I only took, like, 6 or 7 points.
I took a bunch of damage, but I regen.
Oh, okay.
It shouldn't be on that layer. It should be on that layer. And this line, I don't know what layer I've got it on. Let me try map layer. Do I have a map?
That was quite a battle with those phantom-like warriors. I've almost recuperated. By the way, where is Sylvia?
As I do remember stating this last time, that I do play with my rage in, like, focused rage, so I don't know if I saw Sylvia. Should I do, like, a perception check to see if I saw her when I broke down the wall?
You probably would not have, because as I remember the sequence, she had the hand beating it down as she stepped back, trying to stay away from what was going on. So she turned around then while you guys were finishing the fight and headed, trying to grab that smoky dragonette. She tried to grab it, and so she pretty much was out of sight when the wall came down. But as things are going on, it doesn't take a moment of you guys standing here kind of looking around, counting noses, before you see a small little doll form that you have seen before tottering down the hallway towards you.
Do I remember that she has this doll?
I would.
Because I know she kept it secret from us. I don't know if we even knew about it when we had the fight with Baba Lasaga.
Well, I remember kicking it, so Victor says, that thing again!
In which case, I see a Strahd puppet and I start to get angry right away.
It's going to turn. It'll turn and run back, I think, if it's easier.
Yeah, I give chase.
You also have this experience with the Strahd-looking doll that was in the creepy thing where he threw you in on Halloween.
Right. I'm very angry now. I am chasing
it. Actually, technically, you guys would have seen the puppet from when we had it at the shop.
All right,
and that was the last time you saw me with that
puppet. But it wasn't moving on its own at the shop.
Yeah, that's true, too.
We don't know that it was enchanted.
Yep.
No.
I'm giving chase with my spear out, ready to attack it.
Does
on the run.
Does the doll have a voice?
I don't think so. It probably would make some like weird, like tiny little like just run.
Okay, so it just makes emotes, and it clacks its mouth together several times like, and turns around and starts to run from Dirok.
Vlad, we should go this way.
Technically, it's following the orders. A friend is following it, so it's going back to Sylvia.
Yep.
So it runs, patter, 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 patter. This little tiny doll, only about this high, is running down the hall, and it's a sock puppet kind of thing. It has the cloth on the bottom. So
I thought it was more like a ventriloquist dummy.
It is. It's got the clacky mouth, okay. But you insert your hand up into the sock puppet thing, and then you can move the mouth, or maybe it has a gizmo from inside to move in the mouth, but it's like he's running in a dress, basically, is what's going on.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, he's like this little guy in a dress going down the hallway with Dirok hot on its heels. All right, well, let's stop Dirok there. Victor has taken off after Dirok and whatever he's chasing.
He called to the others first. He said, Vlad, Nepotis, we should go this way.
Okay, Vlad, Nepotis, what are you doing?
We're like just beating the crap out of each other. That's like...
just good old boys.
We're having a D&D equivalent of a pillow fight.
Right.
Wow.
Okay,
so are you guys going to stay in that room or move out?
We're moving out. Or I'm moving out.
We follow.
Yep, I'll move Vlad.
And remind me, Vlad, what is the blue and yellow hazes? Are they still active?
I mean, how big is the blue one?
20 feet radius.
That's probably Spirit Guardians. It lasts for 10 minutes.
Okay.
The big one is
detect magic.
Probably detect magic, and it should last for also 10 minutes.
Okay, so it probably... You're getting close... The battle, if you threw this at the beginning of the battle, which you did certainly on the detect magic, you threw it way back a ways, you would be getting close to the end of it. The Guardians, however, would probably still have about 5 minutes left on them.
Right.
All right, so the Strahd puppet moves as fast as its little non-legs can carry it towards the stairway and starts up the stairway.
I continue to give chase.
Oh, I can just picture the puppet right now jumping up the stairs like Mario. So doing that whole like little like.
Is everybody following the puppet?
Yep.
All right, then yep. Let me copy it and move it over as well. And I will move all of you to the new map where Sylvia is. One second. I know you'll see mostly black at the moment or whatever. Don't worry, I'll have you set up here in a moment. And I need these. That would be coming up the stairway with, let's get the puppet out of here before I wind up having it in the middle of everybody. Come on, puppet. We need you.
Oh, did even drag and drop the icon?
No, it's right here. I just couldn't bring it out of the group. Okay, now I'll move the people into place. Victor was second, Depotis and Vlad were bringing up the rear, and now I'll put the group of you on the map. The token layer. All right, now you should be able to see. Anybody that can't see? Okay. So the puppet goes chattering wildly to Mama Lynn, to Mama Sylvia, and grabs at her leg and hangs on as Dirac is coming behind it.
I stop and I look confused as to why it's by Sylvia not attacking.
And as you stand where you are, you begin to see things in the room to the north of you. You begin to see the things I described to her. A long dining table with six slumped skeletons. Slumped skeletons. Seated in chairs alongside.
Vlad will flip down his eye patch of death perception and look at the skeletons.
Oh, they are definitely, they have an aura around them. They definitely are undead. Not just dry skeletons.
Those are definitely going to try to attack us if we mess with them.
Then we should attack first.
Or leave them be.
I look back to Apotus.
Is there a way for me to tell if these are just basic skeletons or if they are something more?
They are dressed in tattered, worn, rusted garb that looks like it was once knightly garb. It all matches, with the exception of the skeleton that is seated in the upper right chair. It is wearing armor that has some insignias on it, as if it was perhaps an officer or a ranking person of some kind.
Maybe I shouldn't have said that. I would have probably recognized that it was probably a knight and not, you know, typical undead.
But they don't look like the knight whites from before?
The ones that were downstairs?
In the chapel, yes.
They look, the armor looks very similar.
Yeah, I don't think I would have actually said that then. I'm smart enough to notice that, oh, these guys look similar. We probably want to save them. Because I did want to save the two knights in the chapel before.
I would prefer to avoid a fight if possible. Let's see if we can find a way around. Is it possible to get around them?
We're in a hallway. They're in a room. We're in a hallway.
I mean, you...
Is there any reason for us to go into that room?
Not necessarily.
I don't see there. I don't think I see any doors, so I don't think there is.
There are some doors on the. Let me open this in a way that will reveal it a little better, because the way I did it, it is a little hard to tell.
I managed to get the laptop, and I'm on roll 20, but I can't see anything.
Maybe roll back out, because we're like in the middle of the entire black screen.
Scrolled out the entire way. Okay. I can see my token, I just can't see anything around it.
Maybe you don't have the character token attached to you yet, because it is attached to me.
No, it's attached to him too. It's attached to all three of you. I don't have any idea why his would be different, that he wouldn't, except that he's on a different version of the program, but I see no reason. Let me double check the character sheet. Just to make sure, and of course it's going to take forever to bring it up. I'm on roll 20, thank you. Edit, come on, you can do it. Goodness, come on. Yep, Vlad, Sylvia, and Dirok are all attached to it. There's no reason. Let me check one other thing. No, I don't want that. Let me check your settings for seeing stuff. That's the only other thing I can think of. Do you have sight?
You had sight. What?
Yeah, there's no reason that you shouldn't be able to see. It's something weird to do with the way Roll 20 is set. Because, let me try something just a second. I'm going to delete your token entirely. And I'm going to pull it out again. Do you see anything now?
No.
Then I haven't got a clue. It's something about the off computer you're using.
Are we sure that Vlad has dynamic landing turned on?
That has nothing. It only happens on my end.
That doesn't have anything to do with the token. Yeah, I'm just blind.
Yeah, because the only thing that you have on your end is whether you have sight or I marked you as blind, and you have sight. So, yeah, there's nothing there. Shortly, once you guys have explored some, I will be turning off the fog of war, but that's the only thing I can see. Let me
I was just going to say,
yeah, from my end, I do control L to see what dynamic lighting looks like on your character, and it shows it perfectly. You're seeing exactly what you should see. So I don't know why your version. You might try dropping out of Roll 20 and reloading.
That's what I'm trying right now. In any case, carry on.
All right. So, here you are, a big pile of rubble in the middle of the T. Sylvia standing there with a silly grin probably on her face with a puppet basically doing a save me mommy hug on her leg, and the four of you standing in front of her looking at skeletons in a room above. What is anybody going to do, or actions?
I'm just gonna cross to see if I don't aggro anything.
Epo discharges.
I'm just gonna wave at them. It's like, if you stay in the hallway and keep your voices down, I don't think they're gonna move.
I'm having a little trouble deciding if a POTUS is serious or not. Is a POTUS charging?
So they all look like they're just totally undead and all that fun.
They look like skeletons to you,
like skeletons.
Without the special thing that Vlad has. They look like they're just skeletons slumped at a table as if they were killed where they sat and have rotted away over the years.
Yeah, he put his peers around the corner then, and he just tries to divine sense.
And you can definitely detect the undead, same as Vlad, when you do that. There is no doubt. However, you don't get a feeling of terrible evil. You get a kind of an almost neutral sense about them. There's neither a great sanctification nor a great evil sense to them.
Victor walks over the doorway like this. Does that make sense?
Okay, so you're just like skirting the doorway?
Yeah, I'm using spider walk, and I'm just going to walk.
Oh, I see what you're doing.
He's just grudging it across.
Okay, so he
basically grudging.
Okay, so you are you just go up and over the doorway so they can't see you.
Yeah, I'm like, just do that.
Yes, let's all get spider walk out as well.
Show off.
All right, so there is no Vlad and Apotis have a very definite sense that there is an unlife in these skeletons. You can feel the sense that it has some kind of soul left to it, but no real evil sense that you can detect, and as I said, no great sense of good either. It just, you have a kind of a neutral feeling, but you can definitely tell there's a soul residing in these skeletons. There is the very slightest movement, as if a hand is moving slightly towards a sword from the upper right-hand chair. That one that
Hippotus rushes in.
That looks a bit different. Okay, so you genuinely
are? Yeah, now he's rushing in. Yeah.
Okay, so you're going to head directly for the one that's moving?
Yes. And I will take a swipe at him with the sun sword. Once he enters the room is when he does it, because then Victor is blind.
I go and charge in after him.
Durok burps and then charges in after
him. Show me where you wind up standing when you charge, Apotis. We'll be rolling initiative.
Which one is the one who moved?
The one that looks different.
Cool.
One of these things is not like the others.
Yeah, he goes for the one that's not like the other then, and he just pulls out the sun sword and just tries.
Oh my god. He didn't.
I'd probably be just right here as he made it.
All right, so I am going to do your swing on him.
Would I get just the one or would I get two?
No, you'll get just the one. All right. He is going to attempt to actually do a dodge action.
Well, has he been taking, did he take the dodge action on his last?
No, he's going to like roll out of the chair and attempt to dodge the strike. He rolls forward out of the chair, but I've got to see if he is able to actually make it or not. If this will ever roll. Thank you. Boy. No, he doesn't make it, and he gets hit with 14 damage. He is more knocked out of the chair because he didn't move fast enough, and he is knocked forward, prone. And you hear a voice like out of the depths of hell, almost. It sounds like it is distant. It is coming from almost very far away. And it comes with the sound of wind And a big wind sound comes, and then the voice comes out of it. Why do the living disturb the dead? Are we not punished enough? And it...
Let me liberate you.
Proceeds
I'm going
to
I'm hearing this. And...
Everybody roll initiative.
It's nothing personal. He disturbs me all the time.
I'm just going to stand there and start covering my face with my hands at this entire thing. And I'm like, I shouldn't have gotten them. I should have just continued on my merry way and then told them after.
Woo! I act tomorrow.
I mean,
yeah,
we did.
No!
We did tell you this, O'Sealy.
See, I did not make the bad mistake. That was the bad mistake.
No, see, you made the bad mistake by leaving us without telling us where you went.
I got someone to tell you, and then you proceeded to act on your own devices without waiting for any explanation or even questioning why.
Kind of like a certain bard.
One,
went off on their
two,
own
three,
devices
four.
Without,
somebody,
you know.
Somebody
us
hasn't
know
rolled it yet. Who hasn't rolled?
Oh, Vlad. It would be Vlad. Where is his character sheet? Sorry. I forgot that I was on Vlad duty. Here we go. Oh, and I didn't have his thing marked. His would be the 9.
Okay. I'll add him real quick here then.
And I need to adjust mine to 23.
We are shared in...
And get it in order.
Reaction.
Alrighty. So... The Sylvia got the highest roll. What is Sylvia going to do as she realizes that Ipotas charged in to attack the undead?
Well, technically, Durak and I are tied on initiative, but
There is an added factor. There is an added factor in there that you don't see.
Oh.
You won the roll.
Oh, okay. Oh, cool. Yeah, I won the coin toss. Oh my god. I'm gonna look back over the pile of rubble. I'm gonna look back at the room. I...
10.
Yeah, no, I...
9.
I'm not gonna do a damn thing then. I'm just gonna sit here and shake my head. That is all I'm gonna do. Is like,
oh,
nope.
We lost Vlad again.
Yep. Dirok.
Is this table like still standing?
Yes, it's in pretty good shape for compared to much of the. This whole room is, but the banners that are on the walls, which are warriors' banners, you know, knights on horses charging into dramatic battle with a lance, with a flat pennant flying, and this kind of thing there, but they are time-worn. They are rotting. The tapestries are rotting out. They don't look like they were destroyed. They look like they have just rotted away over time.
Okay. And then has any of the other skeletons
They are starting to rise, yes.
Alright, then I'm going to stand right here and I shall rage and attack this one on my right side.
Okay.
Make sure I'm on Dirok because I have 2 pages now. Let's be raging. 14?
Does hit one.
And another 14.
Both of those hit for 23 damage. There is an angry hiss from the one that you strike.
And
you and can
I'm
see
just
it
roaring.
To drag out its weapon. Vlad is next. What is he going to do? There is a... to describe what you're...
Aggro. So we're in combat with these things now?
Yes. Can you see?
No. I shut off roll 20 because I can't see. I
All right. You're still showing on here was why I didn't know you're still showing as being on the game. You might be able to pull up Twitch. Might pull up Twitch, and you can at least see the map. Don't turn up the sound, but you can see the map.
Let me try.
I will come back to his turn in a moment. Victor, what are you going to do?
All right. Let's see. So Victor is going to go ahead and take a step into here. Let's see. And he says, you just had to pick a fight. You just had to do it. Let me measure this real quick. Oh, nice. I'm going to drop a moonbeam. I think I can face it before.
Somebody's mic, maybe Mike's mic, is scratching. Or is it Lynn? No, it's not Lynn.
Okay. It might have been Mike, and he just turned his off.
Yeah, my mic's been muted, so.
Okay.
Look, let's shed some light on the situation and maybe we can figure this all out. Eh?
Very good. Okay, and your moonbeam is 10-foot radius or 10-foot diameter?
5-foot radius, so
okay, so one of the squares. Very good. And where are you going to place it?
Placing it now, it's screwed up. But it should hit those bottom four.
Okay, without affecting, I'll draw a circle here one second. Just hang on, I'll draw a shape. And drag it over. Oh, you've already got it, okay.
Yeah, mine was slightly too small, but it's the... Actually, are these 10-foot squares?
Yes.
Then I'll just draw one and drag it into place.
Okay. So, you already had one.
Yeah, but it was actually slightly smaller than it should be.
Okay.
There we go.
There we go. All right. So, your damage on it, you've rolled it.
It's only 5.
Okay, and it's a DC 16 con, so let me do his first. Oh no, he's not in the fight. It's these four that are, they need the con save, so ignore that first one. One, two, it's two saves so far. 12 is not. And the last one is another 12. So an 18, a 21, a 12, and a 12. So the two nearest you saved, the two furthest from you failed, and each took 5 damage on them. And the two nearest ones took 2. Alrighty, so Vlad, are you able to see anything on Twitch yet?
Yeah. Great. Yeah, I can. Can you hear me?
Yes. So you can now at least know what the room looks like and give you some idea of what is going on.
Indeed. Gore, I have a question for you about Vlad's sheet.
Sure.
How many second and third level spells do I have left?
You have, for second level, you have 2, and for third, you have 2.
All right, Vlad will walk into the room, and he will cast... I really don't want to be fighting these things.
I'm only fighting he'll because the POTUS is fighting.
He'll walk into the room, and he'll cast Hold Person on one of the Revenants, one of the ones near the POTUS. Let's see if it even works.
So the one at that's currently at the head of the table and down on his hands and knees, or the one on the other side of a POTUS?
Let's do the one at the head of the table.
All right. So Hold Person. Cast is Hold Person, please. Yeah, thank you. Yep. As you can see, target must succeed on a wisdom. And your DC is 17. Okay. Wisdom DC, and that is... That's Sir Godfrey. Wisdom. There we go. Oh, he failed.
It does affect them. Good.
All right. So he is basically held down on the floor, and he will not be able to get up to rise until he breaks the hold on it. Is where it basically.
Hold Person. It is. Just a quick rundown. Hold Person, the creature is paralyzed. All attacks against it have advantage because it's prone. Range attacks have disadvantage against it anyway. So I think it would just even out. Any melee hits turn into auto crits, and it can only attempt the save at the end of its turn.
Very good.
So that's my option.
All right.
I'll step back out of the doorway.
Victor has had his turn. The skeleton who is on its hands and knees hisses up, and its eyes glow and almost pierce into you, Apotus, and you get a sense of the deepest sadness you have ever felt as you look into those eyes. It's not a spell. He is not attempting to affect you or to make you feel something. You simply, as you look into the eyes of this skeleton, you realize that he has suffered a great tragedy, and you feel intense sense of failure and just utter despair as you look into his eyes. And he looks up and goes, "Why are you a servant of the Dark Lord too? I will die here again, and I will come back again. I will never fail my oath." And that's all it can do.
We are.
At the current moment,
Thank you, Apotus. We are.
And all the other skeletons stand from their chairs. They were in the process of standing, and they all stand. Every one of them, Dirok, you are going to get an attack of opportunity. I never can remember on attacks of opportunity, if there are two targets, can you attack only one?
I think it's only
attack.
One.
Single right. attack.
Both what? Of... Both
I'm having a real problem staying connected to COS.
Yeah, you're not on the best connection situation, so don't worry about it. We just wait. You come back in a moment. All five of these others will stand, and they are all moving towards Apotus. Dirok, you may choose either of the two nearest you to make an attack of opportunity if you choose.
I will, and I'll attack the one that I was attacking.
All right. That is a hit.
That'd be 15, and that's only 12, not plus 8.
And all of them will take all the movement necessary to encircle Apotus. Let's see, 10, 20, yep, you can too. They can all make it. one way or another. One of them actually comes straight across the table at him, but they all strike a POTUS. Alrighty, I need these guys, and I
maybe I get the stamp this week.
Yeah, bye, opponent.
Alrighty. Oh, yes, I forgot. Let me check something on him. I bet he has that ability, too. Need to make sure. Yeah. Start of his turn, so I've got to do something here. Just a moment. And the one that Dirac hit is this one. That affects it, too. And then this one. I gotta check on it. Come on, open up. I gotta look at one that's got full health. Is this one? Yeah, it must be. Yeah, that would have been. No, it would have been this because it was 5 points on that one. I've got to remember what it had. So this one now is this. And this one. 5, 10, yep. Will be. And that one's got it. And this one. That's a POTUS. And this one gets, okay. All right, as you watch them move towards Epotus, you can see some of the damage from your sword as it struck. You can see some of the damage, or your spear as it struck, some of the damage repairing. The moonbeam damage doesn't seem to repair as much. But you can see some of the physical damage where you struck Dirac actually knitting back together on the skeleton. And okay. So now that brings us to long swords. We have 5 characters. You're gonna get 10 long sword attacks, Apotis.
Beat 21.
Up, and we'll start at the 12 o'clock and go around the clock. Rock around the clock tonight. 2, 3, 4. All right, the first two, come on. The first two don't make any hits. The next two, you said 21. Yep, that doesn't hit. One hits for 19 slashing damage. One more to, let's see, no, that's one. We still have 2 more to go. 1, 2, that's the next to last one, no hits. And the last one, one hit for 15 slashing damage. So you've now taken 19 and 15. And the second one is a crit for 24 slashing damage.
Victor just ended, just put the moonbeam over him.
Yeah, that was a pile. Even with only a few hits. Are you still up?
I'm still at 24.
Very good. So it is your turn.
Okay, so they're clearly attacking me for some reason. I'm not entirely sure.
What a mystery.
What a mystery.
Why would they do that?
Why would they attack me? I'm coming in. I'm trying to kick people's butt and take their stuff. Okay, so... All right. I'm going to make a wisdom roll for myself.
Okay.
Nope. Okay, yeah.
he's being dumb tonight. He's beat Sylvia out
he's
tonight.
He's being dumb tonight.
Yep, Sylvia, you don't have the title. She's not there, I don't think, but...
Bad decisions.
Now it's just a question of what angle do I want to take with this.
I mean, you're in the perfect spot for your sunlight thing.
Yeah, we're going to conquering...
Okay, DC 16 wisdom, or they are all feared.
Or they are a frightened. Yes, and he pulls out his shield, and the light kind of radiates out of it, and he roars a command in Draconic to stand. But after he does this, he puts the sun sword away.
I'm rolling for them to see if what responds, and then more importantly is his. Let's see what he does. If it will ever come up. Okay. You get most of them, the ones who were attacking you, the five, you get no reaction from them. But the one who is on the floor, although he can't move his entire body, his head snaps up and he stares at you again. And he is confused. He is trying to figure out what you are. There is a definite confusion factor. And when the sword went away, the whole group of them look like they are turning to the one on the floor, trying to figure out what he wants them to do. There's just this moment of confusion, and their heads turn to him, and he is staring at you. Sylvia, are you going to do anything? She's not there.
She's still AFK.
Dirok, what are you going to do?
Blind Rage. Let's do a wisdom check. Nope.
Nobody smashy, has smashy. Any wisdom tonight.
Smashy, smashy.
Okay.
26 and a 12.
The 26 hits for 13. And Vlad, what do you want to have happen on your end?
Vlad, will drop concentration on the hold person for the skeleton at the head of the table, the leader, apparently.
All right.
So that one is no longer paralyzed.
All right.
And he will recast hold person on Dirok.
After I attack, now I'm screwed.
Yeah.
They're going to come and attack me.
Well, let's just see.
Okay. So we've right, got so, a whole person on Dirok.
I'm out of second level spells.
All right.
So I need a wisdom saving throw, and I have to beat a 17.
Yeah.
All right, I need to see if I beat the 17. Dang it.
So you are held. And Victor... What are you going to do about this moonbeam?
Hold on. Can we continue here?
Yeah, go ahead.
Vlad was going to walk back into the room and say, "We are not your enemies. We are here to defeat Strahd, not to aid him. We have already started to seek out Lord Argenvostold." Argenvost.
And you see, you can just barely see the leader at the head of the table, and his head turns in your direction. He can't see you very well from where he is, but he now is turning and he's looking back and forth between the two of you.
Is he still on the ground?
Yes, he's still prone because he hasn't been able to get up. He's just not been held now, so he will be able to get up this time.
Am I able to, like, stick my hand out towards him?
I'll let just a hand movement be like a
free Yeah, just a hand movement. Yeah, he just puts the sword away, does the conquering, puts the sword away, and then holds the hand.
So you're just, like, doing a stop?
No, just, like, you know, like...
Extend the hand
like, to
feet.
Like, yeah, to help him back to his...
So you're offering the hand of friendship with no sword in it kind of thing.
Yeah, he puts the sword away.
Phone home.
Yeah. All right, so first thing that happens is this has to go on, so he's... And you notice the damage that you made, Apotus, pretty much disappears on him. A little bit of it remains slightly from the radiant damage of the sword, but there a large portion of it has again healed itself on him. And he looks up at you with his head sort of tipped to the side, and there's a feeling, is he going to or is he not? And finally, with hesitation, he reaches out and takes your hand and accepts the help to stand up. He is now standing in front of you, but his hand is still on his sword.
So on my turn, I'll just move the moonbeam over here.
You. When he does this, when he takes your hands, all of the other revenants bring their swords up in front of their faces the swords are straight up in front of them like this, but they don't make any movement. They stop at that point, waiting to see if they get any orders to attack you. It is your turn, Apotus.
Does he still look damaged?
Only the tiniest little bit.
So Apotus got beat the hell up from that. And he lowers the shield, and he looks at the commander, and then he looks at the other presumably knights, and he says, "It is my regret for the actions that I have done just now. My own oath is to crush any that would even remotely appear as servants that could have been left behind. I do not know what to say other than my apologies."
"It is good. You have stopped. Are you an enemy of the Dark Lord?"
"My oath is specifically to crush everything that he is."
"Then you serve the cause. We must defend the castle for eternity. Until he is punished, or until
then you are as the ones upstairs, or downstairs, or whatever, in the chapel."
"We are knights of the Silver Dragon. I am Sir Godfrey Quillam."
I guess Apotus takes no action.
"Then I will consider you out of combat."
I'm still in the hold person.
Yeah. Okay. So what is Dirok going to do? I will go directly to Dirok.
I need to go and do a wisdom saving throw to break out, which I do. I don't get an attack roll or anything, do I?
Well, that you are my action. You have on your turn. You can decide what you are going to do if you're still raging and in a battle.
Well,
I
technically am not, because I haven't done a turn of damage or taken damage, so I'm out of rage.
If he broke out of the spell, it's at the end of his turn, and so his turn's over.
Yeah, I can't attack or do anything else.
All right.
But now I'm pretty angry because I don't know why I was not unable to move. Although I do have kind of a feeling, because I believe Vlad has done this to me before.
Have I?
I know you've done something to me before. I just don't know if it was Hold Person or something else.
And
I think it was Victor who charmed you before.
Victor has charmed me twice, but he hasn't held my action. Someone else has held my action before.
I don't remember. Anyway.
So no one is going to take an offensive action this round, correct?
Yeah,
pretty much.
All right, so I will consider you out of combat. And the skeleton who identified himself, the revenant who identified himself as Sir Godfrey Gwillem, he takes his sword out and he holds it, you know, in a way that shows that he's not taking it out for any kind of offensive move. And he does the same thing as the others, and he puts it in front of his face and he says, "We are sworn to help anyone who will destroy or punish Strahd."
"Then help us. We are here searching for something that..." Bless you. "We are here searching for something that may aid us in the fight. We found something on top of this castle. We're not quite sure what it is. Some sort of contraption. Do you know what this is?"
"It is a beacon. It
a
is
beacon.
The holy light of the Morning Lord. But it is forever extinguished until Lord Argenvost returns."
"I wonder if that is the light that we need to bring," says Captain Obvious.
Anyone else have any questions to ask of him?
Hey, Durham.
Your POTUS actually does. Because this guy looks like Sir Godfrey dressed in a manner suggesting that he was like the boss, or like does his armor look any different than?
His armor looks different. It has in rank of insignia. It's not hugely better quality, but it is. It does have ranks of insignia. The others have moved away, giving room and space to this now. And there is on the front of his chain mail, there is a silver dragon with its wings spread on it, which indicates some kind of rank or higher nobility of some sort.
"Forgive me if this seems a bit indulgent, but have you ever seen this before?" And he pulls out the dagger of serendipity and holds it up for him.
And I need to remember what that was.
That was the little trinket dagger that I got that was held by Uncle Awak.
Got it. Where did I have that listed? So I need the stats is what I'm And of course, nothing's typing. There we go. Appendices, magic items. There it is. Let's see what this reads. So we help put it down where everybody can see it. If the dagger's on your person, you can call on its luck to reroll an attack roll once held by the uncle of the POTUS, who journeyed into Barovia. Ah, and it has, yes. All right. He looks at it and nods and says, "That is one of the daggers that was once carried by the knights. Was your uncle a knight? I do not remember any of your kind among our order."
I do not know. He disappeared some time ago and then briefly returned before he passed and gave this to me.
He nods. "You have a holy relic of our order. But if it was fairly won and fairly taken, it is yours."
"If my uncle served in your order and you recognize this as one of yours, then..."
"There were many centuries of our order. It is possible he served at a time that was not at the end when I served."
"Then, to fulfill the oath of my uncle, I will do what I can to release you from your bonds and deal with the devil myself."
"We cannot be released until Argenvost returns. Only he can remove our oath."
"And that is what I will..."
And he nods and steps back with the others.
"I have another question."
Hey, yes. Hey, hey. Don't do that, do you?
What?
But you weren't talking to me. Okay.
Oh, sorry.
"On our way up here, we saw several different statues of who we presumed to be Lord Argenvost, yet each of them were slightly different. In fact, one of them seemed to be enchanted, and when I first looked at it, it showed the face of my companion here," and he gestures to POTUS. "Says, do you happen to know anything about these?"
"These statues I know well. He made one, had one carved for each of his many human forms. But as for a curse that would make it look like your friend, I know nothing of this. It is probably part of the curse that has fallen on this hold."
"One of his many mortal human forms. Why? I thought dragons had only one human form. Was he able to take on multiple?"
"Each time he became a human, he could choose among several forms that he would use. He liked to walk among the people and not be recognized."
"Vlad, has this ever been recognized as one of his forms?" And he will describe the form of Lord Vasily von Holtz that Strahd took. "Were they different? Were they ever different, or were they the same?"
"The form that you saw, how close did you see von Holtz? You saw him from a distance?"
"Von Holtz was at the monastery. Von Holtz was at the abbey, right?"
"Right. But you saw him from a distance, right?"
"Yeah."
"Yeah, you wouldn't know, but he would frown a bit as best he could with very little flesh left on his skull, and he would say, 'Von Holtz? No, he never used that name. That does not sound like something he ever called himself.
I know that there is something useful here, but I'm not certain what it is. Is there anything else that we would be able to find here that could be useful? What about that mausoleum out in the yard?
That is where Argenvost should have slept when his time came, but he was not permitted to sleep in his final grave.
Was his time near?
No, he would have lived many, many centuries yet, but he was taken before his time, and his body was disassembled, and part of it was taken to the castle. And he waves his hand towards Ravenloft.
You said that the beacon will not be lit once until Lord Argenvost returns. Yet if his body is in pieces, would simply returning his head be enough?
I do not know, but I would hope so. If at least a portion of him can return, then the curse will be lifted.
And this beacon, the only way to light it is if Argenvost returns?
Correct, to the best of my knowledge.
Is there anything of use that we might find in the mausoleum if we go inside?
I do not know. I have been here for a long time, but it was empty, prepared for Lord Argenvost's eventual death. I do not know if anything dwells there now.
Does anyone else have any questions?
You already asked what I was going to ask.
Is there anything within the castle itself that may aid us in the retrieval of Lord Argenvost?
I do not think so now. The only item that may have aided you was stolen a long time ago, and I am afraid that it has driven Vladimir completely insane. If he still roams these halls, beware, because he is not the man I loved.
Who?
Vladimir.
Vladimir Horngard. He was the reigning knight of the Order.
Like his Argenvost second?
Yes.
And what is this item that Vladimir has stolen?
He did not steal it. He was sworn to protect it and keep it from Strahd's hands. But it was taken, and we know not where. It was a book, a diary. Written in the Dark Lord's own hand.
Didn't we come across a certain
book? No, we didn't.
Okay, then we found a certain book. Sorry, I'm like hiding off camera because I'm not feeling good.
You want me to put your picture up? Lynn, you want me to put your picture up to make it easier for you?
No, it's fine. I'll pop in and out, but I'm just like, if I'm leaning too far over to one side, it's like, I don't feel good, so I'm just going to lean and just going to keep like disappearing.
Very good. All right, back to Vlad. What our Vlad, what did you ask him?
I didn't ask him anything this time. I said, Celia, yes, we already found that book. But I can't differentiate between Lynn and Sylvia, so.
No, I'm asking OOC on that one. Like, yes, on the I see Sylvia's just kind of like overhearing and kind of like keeping an eye because she knows that smoke dragon is somewhere around the corner. She's like, "You still there?"
Yeah, I just look over at Vector because I think he has that book that was mentioned.
Vector will pull out the book.
Sir Godfrey, would you be able to tell the rest of the whites here that, or the soldiers, guards here, that we are friends of Lord Argentvost and intend the doom of the Dark Lord?
I can tell none but those in this room, and they have already accepted my order to stand down. I cannot communicate with the others. They are under the control of their own commanders. Those with Vladimir will follow his orders, and those with the captain of the guard who were sworn to protect the chapel will follow his orders.
Didn't we make nice with that one? At least the chapel ones.
Is Vladimir in the chapel?
Yeah, sorry.
No, I believe he still roams in rage on this floor.
I see. Since we are not able to light the beacon, can you see any point in us continuing up to the roof?
Only to know what is up there and what has befallen the castle, but the return of Argentvost is that which you must undertake in order to have the beacon.
I see. Hey, Gore, how much gold do I currently have?
You have, as soon as I go to this core gold, you have zero.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah, you have like 6 silver pieces. That's all that I see on your sheet.
Okay.
You never mind. Broke, my friend.
Plate mail, not cheap.
You are impoverished. You have taken the vow of poverty. You are now a knight.
Yeah, I mean, I still have 295 gold. I don't know what it was you were planning to do, though.
I was planning to cast Continual Flame on the beacon.
Oh. Yeah, you're not getting my gold for that.
Anyway. Well, it seems we have nothing left here to do. We thank you for your vast array of knowledge.
And he puts his hand to his chest, still holding the sword in one hand, puts his hand to his chest and bows in respect to you. My enemies are your enemies, and I am sworn to assist you.
I have a question. About how large was your lord, Argentvost?
In his dragon form or his human form?
Was in his dragon form. I'm assuming that is his remains that was kept.
In his dragon form, he was large enough to cover half of the battlements on the roof. He was enormous.
I nod.
I just clicked on that GIF. Oh my goodness. For our audience, it's a GIF that got posted of a cat with its head stuck in a slipper and trying to get out. Oh my goodness. Anyway.
Context of that is that's how Epotis felt this entire fight.
Yeah. Yeah.
Completely helpless.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say for the fight, I'm pretty much just standing against the wall, just like, sitting there with the puppet just looking at it.
Yeah, we all voted that you won the award last time for the dumbest choice, and tonight POTUS did.
Yep.
Yep. Yeah. I was seriously, I was like, all signs pointed to me was like, no, it's just, I rolled ridiculously high on the initiative, and I'm like, I'm just not getting involved, because that was, all signs pointed to don't fight them. Like, everything told me no.
Okay, so he has answered all those questions. Does anyone have any other questions? Sylvia, you haven't asked anything. I don't know if you have any questions hanging around the edges.
No, I'm just going to let out a small, sharp whistle to get someone to come back out in the hallway. So I can at least tell them, it's like, yeah, so before y'all charged off into that room and started to make friends the fun way, there was a thing I was following that went over this way.
I don't think we're venturing any further in.
It was kind of a smoky dragon.
Smoky dragon.
Yeah.
Did it look like the fiery dragon from the hearth downstairs?
Only in OOC, I'll answer. It was a dragon form, and, you know, all dragons look alike.
It could have been, I guess. I don't know. Maybe it's connected to the one guy who's got the thing that you guys were just being told about. I followed the smoke dragon. I saw the skeletons, and I said, no. And so I waited for you guys, and then you all just saw skeletons, and you're like, hey, let's attack something that's not moving, because that's such a genius idea. And I thought, I made bad mistakes, guys.
You did make a bad mistake by leading us up here into this fight.
I didn't get you into the fight. You started the fight yourselves.
And we wouldn't have been up here for the fight if you hadn't run up here on your own.
Yeah, like they wouldn't have come up eventually on their own.
Yeah, whatever. Y'all need to live with your choice. I made peace with mine. Mine was just coming up here by myself. Ooh, wait, I stopped and I went and got you guys. Y'all went and just did your own thing.
Okay, so what is the team... You need to regroup and decide whether you're going to go on to find where the dragonette went, or whether you are going to just decide at this point that you are leaving and pull out your heartstone and return to the inn.
Opodus is
right now. I think it is worth discovering what this dragon is doing.
I mean, it might lead us to a clue, could lead us to another fight. I mean,
Okay, well, vote among yourselves, guys. I'm not going to make a decision for you. Okay, so how about you type in the chat in Discord... a 1 if you want to continue here, a 0 if you want to leave. And Vlad, you said you did want to continue?
Yes.
All right, so that's a 1. The rest of you in yeah, he's done it in Discord, okay. But in the Discord chat, because I want to actually have it in the Discord. I said Discord. I meant the game. Yeah, but that's fine.
Sorry.
We've got 1. I did it wrong. We've got 2 1s and a 0. Victor, what do you want?
I'll go with the 1.
Okay, so 3 persons want to continue. POTUS, you say quick rundown. You mean of the alternatives? It's basically, do you want to continue to explore to see if there's loot or something to be found here, or to return to probably Velaki.
Well, weren't there other rooms?
Mm-hmm. There's lots of other rooms, and there's the battlement and the tower that you saw the harness.
Also remember, though, that we the guy said that only he can command those in the room, which means if we find any future skeletons, we're going to have to fight them as well.
Or you could
you
let
like
the...
This is Apodus, who fights undead. We're not going to just parlay right away. He's going to charge in head first, and he's almost ready to lose his head with how low his health is.
Well, then, you know, maybe he should just get knocked down on his ass and then he'll learn. I mean, you're never going to learn until you get knocked on your ass.
You do make a valid point.
Apodus.
I'll change it to a one.
Victor looks over to the other undead in the room and he says, hey, could you write us a note maybe? It would make things way simpler.
A note from your mother that you really did lose your homework. Oh my goodness. Okay, so it looks like even if a POTUS says, no, we're leaving, the vote has gone against him. They're going to snag him and drag him out of the room, and they're going to go find out what's going on. So, POTUS, hopefully you've got some heels hanging around somewhere, because your crew is headed off.
I'm serious, though. I'm asking for a note.
Will you,
Sir Gwillem responds, no, it will do no good. Once he would have listened to me beyond all others, but the love we shared is gone. There is no more, and sadly, he is not the man I remember.
Well, that sounds ominous.
Gore, will you roll 1d6 plus 1d4, please?
Let me get back on the thing. / roll 1d6 plus 1d4. That is a 4. You rolled a 2 and a 2.
Lovely. Apodus regains 14 hit points as I use my bandages.
Okay, Apodus, you're 14 points to the better. So
We'll let him know when he gets back. He had to go AFK, kid's crying.
Okay, be sure and tell him that I've added 14 points to him, okay?
Alright.
Alrighty. So he is up a little bit. Still down, but he's up a little bit. Alrighty, so he will follow along behind you, staying a little bit back this time, I assume. All right, Sylvia, I guess you're kind of, since you're the one who saw this dragonette, I suppose you're kind of leading this crew. What are you doing with the Strahd puppet at this point?
It's going to be, trying to figure out the best way to describe it, what I'm doing with it. It's kind of just hanging on to my shoulder and just kind of like draping over the side like a weird little pet.
Got hold of a lock of your hair and hanging on for dear life. Okay.
No, it kind of just like finding one of the little like knots or ties that's like part of the chest piece that she like the corset thing that she has on.
Okay.
And then just holding on, just kind of like holding onto there, or like tucked fingers underneath the shoulder strap type deal.
Victor, are you releasing your moonbeam?
I'm going to hold on to it until the duration runs out, just in case we, like, turn a corner and immediately end up in another encounter.
Okay, so are you leaving the room and following out behind them?
Yeah.
Okie doke. So, Sylvia...
Lead the way, Sylvia.
You'll have to start clambering over the pile of garbage in the hallway. But eventually, there's nothing obstructing you other than the garbage. So eventually, you are able to move up and over the garbage, and you'll be able to see down the hallway. Let me open it up all the way to the end so you can see all of that. It opens out to open air, just like the lower floor. This portion has been broken off in the south, the same as the others. You can see several openings. There's an opening to your right and left where you're standing into rooms. Let me open them completely up so that you can see it. There's a curtain sealing off a doorway in the one that I just opened. And two, as you're facing south, what will be to your right on stage left opens into a room, and there is Sylvia spots the little dragonette sitting on the back of a throne that is facing several windows. The windows are clear, they're not stained glass, and there's three of them in a kind of a hexagonal looking area, half of a hexagonal area. And the throne, its back is to you. And the entire back of the chair is carved like a dragon with enormous spreading wings that go out side to side on the thing. They spread out probably 2 feet on either side of the chair. And they are, the throne is made of wood, but has been gilded. Only the gilt is peeling somewhat and is peeling off. And the small dragonette is sitting on the back of this chair, nestled between the wings of the carved dragon. Let me open this up. So basically, you're seeing this chair and the windows beyond that apparently would have been probably where Lord Argenvoss would have sat to observe his realm and out to his front door, out to the grounds beyond. Perhaps the throne at one time faced the other way, but it does not now. Lying on along the wall on both the north and south side of this throne room, there are remnants of armor, shields, swords. Most of them are not in the greatest of shape, but they are lying scattered all along both walls, all kinds of armaments and pieces of weapons and shields and so forth lying scattered about.
Okay, gonna motion that there, it's there. Yeah, I'm gonna carefully make my way inside and look to see if there might be anybody, like trying to get like a glimpse of an arm or foot or something that might be in the seat. But I'm gonna keep a very, very safe distance.
Okay. So I mean, like, I'll when you can see anything further, you'll be able to see it. With the dynamic lighting, when you move into a position to actually see the chair, you'll know when you have done so.
The case, I grab Sylvia right away because I do see something right there in the throne. I see a little bit of a hint right here.
Yeah, I'm seeing it now too. I mean, I'm not going that far. I'm going to about like here.
Very good.
But I'm keeping myself fairly quiet.
What you can see is the hint of some armor. It's a little finer quality looking armor than what you've seen before on the knights, but an arm is dangling to the side of the throne, hanging down limp. It is only bones remaining in the hand and so forth. The part that you can see is just bones of a hand.
I'm motioning for her to come back. And I think she went AFK again.
No, I'm here.
Oh, okay. then I'm motioning for you to come back.
I'm leaning in my chair for comfort. And
okay.
Yeah. So, but no, I'm still here.
I'm motioning for Sylvia to come back. Also, Mink is trying to get Discord to come back.
Right, right. I know. For our viewers, let me just turn the photos on for now and the videos off so that we don't have to worry about the...
I think we discombobulated. Unless this is him, just rejoining. Hey, he's back.
Yeah, he just keeps coming up. So I'm going to put us back onto, for a little bit, onto our photos so that we don't have to worry about it. I'll put mine
if,
on.
If Sylvia's not moving, I'm going to reach for her to try to pull her back. We don't need her to be the first one in the room of a potentially dangerous creature.
I don't think I have to worry about the creature. I think I have to worry about what's in that throne.
That's what I mean. That's why I'm trying to pull you back. If you're not moving back willingly, I am pulling you back.
She'll come back quietly, because if you grab her, she might squeak.
I motion for Epodus before I start towing into the room on one side.
Then Epodus will follow. And as he does, he's going to drop 20 points of his own lay on hand.
Okay.
So.
And you already got 14 from Vlad. That's why you were up a bit.
Yeah.
As soon as Epodus rounds the doorway, I'm going to reach out and attempt to grab an arm and whisper, "Stop making bad choices," and give him the bardic inspiration.
The first time we see bardic inspiration, stop making bad choices, you idiot.
So charge in, got it. What I'm inspired to do so.
Then also as a heads up,
no, you're inspired not to make bad choices.
Also I'll take that into consideration.
Also, remember, as a heads up, because that you can't read Discord.
That reminds me, by the way, you still got that inspiration that you haven't used, in case you ever need
Somebody
it.
Somebody has it. I don't know who I gave it to.
Epodus has inspiration from that I awarded.
Yes. Yeah, I still have it.
Because you can't read Discord, Mink, he just got kicked again. His phone has had it for the night. He's going to let me control Vlad and watch the video to catch up.
Okay. Very good. And hopefully he can watch Twitch a little bit and see what's going on.
Alright. I'm moving a little closer to see
more. We've only got about another 5 or 10 minutes here anyway, so.
Yep. I have my shield and spear ready, but I'm not making any further movement without anyone else coming in.
As you move into position where you are able to see more, you can definitely tell that it's another one of the revenants that is collapsed in the chair. And I've got to see what kind of armor to describe. He has got the armor is in much better shape than any of the others. It is half plate armor. It is very shiny, and you can see as he slumps forward, you can see just one wing showing a little bit on the breastplate of another one of those silver dragon shapes the guy in the other room had, Sir Godfrey had. You can see another one of those on his chest plate dangling loosely from his hand is a large greatsword, and there is some kind of symbol of a dragon hanging from his neck. It's a chain with a dragon on the end of it.
I'm motioning for Apodus to come in.
I'm gonna do a cantrip message to Dirac and go, do you trust me on something?
I don't answer.
He doesn't.
He can't reply.
If you can't say nothing nice, don't say nothing.
Yeah,
If I can't say anything nice, I'm not supposed to say anything.
Iptodus murmurs to Dirac. Says, do you think I should try to look like the...
Like who?
Sir Godfrey.
What about Argenvost's human form?
I don't know what that looked like.
The human bust.
I would need
a whole appearance.
Oh.
I just want to frantically wave near them, going, an idea.
Yeah, we know you have an idea. It's normally a bad idea.
This one might actually work, though. That's the sad part.
What's your idea?
I'm open to suggestions, because apparently I'm not doing anything foolish right now.
Well, I'm going to wait for the others to get a little closer.
Oh, yeah. I guess Vlad would probably be like right here, still
you
far away.
You hear a chingling of chainmail.
There is someone behind us.
It's coming around the corner and crawling over the rubble is Sir Godfrey.
Victor is still back there. So
is it one of our buddies?
Yeah, that's Godfrey. That's the guy we just talked to.
Okay. Now I'm a little concerned.
Oh, hello? Did we drop something?
I wish to see what he would do. I still cannot believe he has turned so completely from the light.
Hearing the voice, I tell Hippotus, probably not a good idea now.
Fair.
I still want to try it. It's a Hail Mary play, but...
I was talking about Apotus' idea, not yours. Apotus was to transform himself into Godfrey, but not going to work if Godfrey's also here.
Yeah.
I did ask what your idea was. It just kind of got lost in the shuffle.
I
see, Lee.
Yeah, I'm going to carefully eke out to about here. Little kind of keep the puppet just out of view so it's not like obviously look there's a Strahd thingy, like I guess maybe order him to go climb back into the backpack.
You read my mind just in time.
I was like, having a Strahd thingy out is not the greatest idea thing right now.
Yeah, I was thinking, now how am I going to have these guys react when they see a Strahd puppet?
So it's just gonna sit there chilling inside the backpack, probably folding clothes. it's a tiny servant. What else is it gonna do? I'm trying to formulate the words right so it doesn't sound too dumb. She's going to stand still, bow slightly in what it was like doing a respect to a nobility almost, and go, heroic knight of Argenvost, we beseech audience to gain your aid. And I'm going to try to do it as a persuasion?
Okay. Go ahead.
Go
ahead and roll your persuasion.
Oh, come on. Plus 13. Don't fail me now.
Oh,
thank you.
Dang. That's a crit.
Thank you. I'm trying to get this as...
I'm looking at
how does persuasion compare to psychic resistance?
Because
this thing is very, very resistant to any kind of psychic charm or anything like that. It can't be charmed or anything like that.
Not necessarily trying to charm it, but trying to a piece to its high ranked status as trying to at least get into this fray with before combat starts and just trying to keep it talking.
Okay.
Instead of just going completely aggressive right off the bat.
It succeeds in that regard. It slowly, you see the bony hand slowly close on the hilt of the greatsword, and it begins to move, and it stands up, and it lifts it and rises, and the other hand comes and joins on the greatsword, and it steps around the chair in that pose you've come to recognize as being the one where the ready pose that the others had. Why is my video not there? I just realized I'm not showing it all on my video, but anyway. Let me just put my picture up and that'll end the problem. I wanted to have my picture up on there, but for some reason it's not showing. Yes, let me do it this way. Hold on just a second, guys. Let me do it this way. See if that changes it. I don't know why I am getting, must be the, because I want to show my movements to things here, so it must be because of this. Let me just take mine off this way. No, that didn't do it either. Why is my video not showing?
Oh no!
Understand. Can't see me at all. In fact, when I do it, you can't see my picture either when I try to do my photo. Anyway, the sword, I'll just describe it since it's causing me problems and we're almost done. The sword raises in front of his face in a ready position like the others held. And again, that dark, distant voice comes out. I do not know who you are, but if you come to destroy me, know this. I perished defending this land from evil over 4 centuries ago. Because of my failure, I am forever doomed. Destroy this body, and my spirit will find a new corpse to inhabit. And I will hunt you down. You cannot free me from damnation, nor would I wish it. And if you have come to free this land from the creature that feasts on the blood of the innocent, then know this. There is no monster on the face of the universe that I hate more than Strahd von Zarevich. He slew Argenvost, broke the life of the knight I loved, and destroyed the valiant order to which I devoted my life. But Strahd has already died once. He cannot be allowed to die again. Instead, he must suffer eternally in a hell of his own creation, from which he may never escape. Whatever can be done to bring him misery and unrest, I will do. But I will destroy anyone who tries to end his torment.
His torment? Have you seen him the last few centuries? He delights in what he has now. There's no torment within Strahd.
I will place him in a torment, and I will make him rue that he ever existed upon this world.
And you're doing a good job in your chair.
Victor steps forward and he removes his hood and he says, indeed, you are not doing much here. I know what it is to live in damnation. Join us And you can help to bring hell to Strahd.
You.
He looks at him, just, you know, pale face, bare.
You are one of them. And what of the rest of you? What do you seek to do to Strahd? I cannot leave my prison. What do you plan to do to him?
Hippotas looks at Sylvie.
Cause him pain, misery, suffering. Bring back every ounce of injustice he has put upon the innocent people, and make him feel it tenfold. But in order to do that, we want any ounce of help you can give us. You help us, we will help you give him exactly what he deserves.
His teeth,
this I vow, this I swear.
His teeth kind of grit. They're grinding together like he's a little bit irritated by what you're saying. As long as you do not let him escape to only be reborn by the evil forces, I will hold my hand. But if you release him from torment, I will destroy you. And as he is saying that, Sir Godfrey steps clear forward into the throne room and raises his hand and says, stop. You cannot mean this. We fought too long not to assist them. And there is an odd look that passes between them. The one who is holding the great sword seems confused, and he pauses for a long time and he stares at Sir Godfrey as if he's trying to remember who he is. And Sir Godfrey and he just stand there staring for a while. But then, as if he sort of shakes himself out of it, the man from the throne waves his arms, and around the edges of the room, six phantom warriors appear. And that is where we will leave it for tonight.
It was ruined the second Godfrey started making his way around here.
Yep.
Could have had this. It could have had it.
It was Godfrey that made the bad decision here.
Yeah.
See, I only made one.
See, I think it's like if this was any other situation, if we had continued down that path, I could have had this. But no, Godfrey showed up. Because it's like, as soon as I realized, it's like, okay, fancy armor. Dragonblink was leading us here. I'm like, okay, based on everything we just heard from the last room, it's like, this is his significant other. And now it's like, okay, his mind is kind of warped, but could he use that to an advantage? Warped mind's not that hard to work with, but nope, he showed up. Confusion abound everywhere.
Yep.
We got this, though.
Even Dirac was smart enough to, like, hold his tongue, because he doesn't want to fight anymore, and he's like, I'm not going to try to give another reason to start a fight. I will be as vague as possible, but I will let him know that Strahd's not in torment. He's not in misery.
That's not what he's saying. He's saying he wants him to be in misery. He knows that he is ruling this land and he's not in torment. He doesn't want him to die. He wants him to be placed into a misery that where he is just for the rest of eternity, he sees what he has done and he is tormented by it and can never, ever be released from it.
That's why I was taking away from the K word and going with, like, no, we'll make sure he feels it all tenfold. You give us aid and we'll do this.
Yeah, he's insane, which Sir Godfrey isn't.
Yeah.
Okay. This is where we will pick it up then next week. Kyle, do you wish to say anything about what's going on with Are You Sure?
Yes, Saturday we're meeting and at about the same start time as this game, and things about to go.
Yeah, some interesting stuff going on with that, and we hope to see you with that. Anybody else got anything going on before we break for the night? In that case, I will say good night all. Well, you can see one hand of me. That's interesting. That's all that's there. The rest of me is, that's because of the videos being all lopsided, I guess. Yeah, okay.
Discord just like poofed me, so.
Yep. So it's everything's all gee-whoppered. Anyway, I will see you next week, and we hope that you have a great week. You need to start your own game, people. The great fun with, that we have here. So we will see you on Crone's Crucible next Saturday and Sunday. Good night, all.